thriving, that specific population of beluga whales is listed as endangered due to their declining population, leaving them at fewer than 300 individuals. Now, Kaonik was found stranded on September 30th, 2017, near the village of Kaonik in Alaska. After recovering at the Alaska Sea Life Center from malnourishment, dehydration, and several other hardships, the decision was made for him to be transported here to SeaWorld San Antonio. And he'll be out here in just a moment for you guys to see him. Now, Kaonik is just over 2 years of age. You'll notice when he makes his appearance that he is a darker gray color. So we've got Betty out here, and Ty is following right behind her, and there he is. I'll give you guys a moment to kind of check him out. Now, like I said before, his coloration is a little bit darker, right? So when belugas are born and they're capped, they're born that dark gray color. Now, this is a form of camouflage. It allows them to blend in with their mother's shadow, which keeps them safer from predators. Now, as they age, they typically will lighten up in color, but not every single beluga gets to be that bright, white, super smooth, beautiful color that you typically think of. Now he is joined out here by Betty. Now Betty is one of our older animals. She is a 41-year-old Pacific white-sided dolphin, and they seem to enjoy hanging out together. Now our park was selected as Kaonik's new home due to us having so much experience. We have over 40 years of experience raising beluga calves specifically. We also have a robust collection of beluga whales. They range in age from 2 years old all the way up into their mid-30s. We even have a couple other whales that were born here at this park that are very close in age to Kaonik. So you've been able to learn a lot by hanging out with those animals, learning things socially, developmentally, all that good stuff, by just hanging out with our pod. He's also learned a great deal of behaviors from us, his trainers. We've been able to teach him on a scale slide out. Basically, we ask him to slide out on our beluga whale size scale in one of our back pools, and it allows us to get an accurate measure of his weight. We do this at least once a week. When he was found in Alaska on the beach, he weighed just 140 pounds. But today, he is weighing in at over 500 pounds, and that's pretty cool. Now, Kaonik is also very important in our research studies. He's participating in several of those currently. One of the main ones that we're trained to do is called a hydrophone vocal development study. So basically what we're doing is we're putting a hydrophone or an underwater microphone in the water to record their vocalizations of our calves and our young animals and our older animals to see if we are able to identify an animal's age based on the vocalizations that we're hearing. So we're hoping that we can use this information for those wild counterparts. Alrighty, well, thank you so much for keeping your attention with me, and now, enjoy Ocean Discovery!
Welcome to Beluga Theater. We want to invite you to come with us, dive into the ocean, and discover some of the world's most fascinating creatures, beluga whales and Pacific white-sided dolphins. Ladies and gentlemen, Ocean Discovery!
environment because it gives her an ability to get really close underneath the eye suit her artist's home. Now, did you notice what color this was? White, that's right. Here you go, you can give her this fish and toss it in her mouth. Oh, got a second roll, she got it. Now, the white coloration helps her blend in to her Arctic environment. There you go. Now, Chloe, you can come up right here next to me and give Luna a nice rub on her back. What is she feeling? Soft? She is pretty soft, pretty squishy. Now, have you ever been kissed before, Chloe? Well, you have. You might want to talk to Mom and Dad about that. ship. Let's reunite land and sea.
About the SeaWorld Busch Gardens Conservation Fund and how you can join the SeaWorld to conserve and protect the natural world we all share, please visit SeaWorld.org.